Hello and welcome to 14th JMeter training video tutorial. We will have a look at custom graphs in this session. So far we have not seen very excellent graphing solutions available from JMeter, in fact from JMeter plugin, and this is the topic for this session. So let's see what we are going to dive in this session. We will see why we need custom graphs, we will see what plugins we need for them, how we can configure these plugins, and how we can have them available in JMeter. After this, we will run our test script, plot some of the graphs, and see how we can visualize the data. So let's begin. So why do we need custom graphs? So what we have done so far is we have used two listeners mostly in JMeter, which is view result in tree and view result in table. These are good enough to provide information about errors, what's happening in the test, transaction rate, response time, and many other factors. But this is not something which gives you a detailed report which you can present to your management. For example, your management would be interested in seeing a line graph in terms of how threads or number of users increase over a period of time, or what happens to the response time when you have thread groups or number of threads increasing from 50 to 100 or 100 to 200, or what happens to the transaction and many other statistics. Now this is something which we cannot have, which we cannot do directly from JMeter, or at least we cannot have very presentable graphs coming from JMeter, but there are lots of plugins available for graphing which we can use here. So let's see what we can do. So first what we have to do is we have to download a couple of JMeter plugins from the URL which is mentioned here, which is jmeterplugins.org/download/all/latest-stable-release. So I have opened it in Firefox here. This is the URL. And then on the download section, there are a couple of plugins. In this part, we are going to download three plugins, which are JMeter Plugins Standard, JMeter Plugins Extra, and JMeter Plugins Extra Lib. We do not need other plugins at this point of time, but probably we will have a look at them in the future session. Now, once you download these plugins, then extract them in your whichever directory you have got them, and then you would see something like this. So this is my terminal program. I'm using Terminator here so that I can show you two different screens on the same console. So I had already downloaded these plugins, and then I extracted JMeter plugin standard jar. And when I extract it, I have this directory structure come up, wherein in the lib folder I have JMeter plugin cmd sh, cmd runner.jar, JMeter plugin standard.jar, and some other files. So as far as JMeter plugin standards plugin is concerned, we need two jar files from here. One is the cmd runner.jar and another is JMeter plugin standard.jar. In the similar way, we need to also download plugin extra and extra library and extract the files in the same manner. So once you download all of these plugins and extract the files, then these are the jar files which are of interest for us. So we have already seen two jar files, which were JMeter plugin standard.jar and cmd runner, and from the extras and extra libraries you get two more jar files, which are extras.jar and extralib.jar. So what you have to do now is you have to copy these jar files into your JMeter lib extra folder. I have already done that. So here I am on JMeter lib extra folder, and if I list the files here, then you can see I have JMeter plugin extra.jar, extralibs.jar, standard.jar, and somewhere, yeah, cmdrunner.jar. So these are the jar files which we need at this point of time. Once you do this, then you have to restart your JMeter, and then you would see more options in terms of listeners. So since I have already done this, I have restarted my JMeter, and this is our old test plan for the Mercury tour, which we have been using from quite some time. And now if I right click on the thread group and go to add listener, then I would see a couple of more listeners here. For example, active thread over time, composite graph, and many other listeners. These are the listeners which were not available before we added plugins. So we have downloaded plugin, we have set up plugins, and the plugins are available in JMeter. So let's see what we do next now. So So let us remove our old test run file. Let's run our sample script and let's plot some graphs and see how it goes. So let me go back to the bin directory. And we used script1.sh in past, so I'm going to use this again here. Let me just show you its content once. Yep. So we are using NewStore application here. The test is run with 3 threads. The duration is 120. The format of file is CSV here, so the test result would be saved in CSV format. And we are printing the field names here. N is, of course, for non-GUI mode test run. Our test plan is here. And the location of test file is also in the bin directory, and the name would be testresult.jtl. If you want to know more about these options, then please watch previous JMeter training video tutorial, wherein I explain them in detail. So let's remove any existing instance of test result file, and let's run our test now by executing this script. All right, so I have begun executing the test, which would run for about 2 minutes. So we can see here that it has created the tree successfully using JMeter public project file, project JMX file. And we have first summary being printed here, wherein we have 10 requests in 11 seconds, which is about 0.9 or 1 request. In 1 second, average timing is 788 millisecond, minimum time is 395, and maximum is 1092 milliseconds. There are 0 errors, which means 0% of the requests have failed. All active threads are 3, all started threads are also 3, none of the test has finished. All right, we have one more summary sample come up here. So now we have 36 samples in 31 seconds. And the total time passed is 42 seconds, which you can see in the last summary sample. So this test would run for 2 minutes, and we would have a test results file, which we would use to plot different graphs in the JMeter listeners, which we configured a while ago. All right, so 80 seconds are over so far. Our test would be over in 40 more seconds. No errors so far. Maximum time is 1100 milliseconds, which is close to 1 second. And the test should be over soon. Let's see when next summary sample pops out. All right, it's close to 115 seconds, which means test should be over soon. No errors. The average response time is 617 milliseconds. So here we see the test is over now. And now we would have testresult.jtl file. I can just look up the file. Yep, so this is the file with the required data. So let's go back to our JMeter now and start adding the listeners. So first we will add active thread over time listener. So I will right click on it and say listener and active thread over time. And now I would load our test result file. So this was in bin directory. So I will go to my home Apache bin, and my test result is available here. You should not be storing your test results or any random scripts in Apache installation of JMeter, but this is just for the sake of demo or for this video, so it's okay. So let me load this file. All right, so we see here that we have a red line and it keeps pointing at 3 here. This is of course because we had 3 threads run in the test. And you can see here the test was run for about 2 minutes. So the duration begins with 00 and it keeps on going till 2 minutes, after which threads are down to 0. All right. There's one thing which is Important here that if you want to change the color of the graph, then you can just double click on thread group and you can select it till you find a color which you like. So double click on it and it would keep changing the graph color. So let's see the next tab here, which is rows. So here you can check or uncheck how many rows you want to display. We have just one thread group here. And then you can also specify the start and end time in seconds. You can include label and also use regular expression to exclude labels and also exclude labels. Then we have some more settings wherein we can specify a group timeline for how many seconds you want to have it. It is by default set for 500 milliseconds. There are some more values here. Something which I use very often is limit number of points in a row to some value. For example, if you have very high number of points, then I limit it to whatever number of points I need. Since we do not have many data points here, hence 50 is also okay. And you can also specify the width of the line. For example, you can say 3 here, and when you say 3, then you see the line is darker than how it was earlier. So let's set it back to 1. All right, so this was our active thread over time. All right, one more property here is the draw marker. I would uncheck it and the graph would look more clearer if I uncheck this. So now you see the graph is more clear. So this is active thread over time. Let's see the next listener here now, which is response time over time. So I would right click on it and add new listener, which is response time over time. So let's just pick this, which is this listener. And we would load the same file again. So we see here response time of three different samples. We have welcome page, registration page, and create account page, and they are available here. As again, if you want to change color of any of the graph, just double click on it and keep double clicking on it till you find a graph color which is suitable for you. Now in the row section, we can check or uncheck any of the samples. And if you uncheck the sample, then it would disappear from the graph. And the settings are same as what we saw in active thread over time. Okay, let's plot the next graph, which is transaction per second. And here we have transactions per second. Let's load our test file again. Yep, so you can see here that create account page, registration page, and welcome page have their transactions being plotted here. Transaction is also known as number of amount of throughput, that is how many requests are served by server in every second. Since create account page is not clearly visible here, I can double click on it and change its color to something which makes it more visible. Rest of the settings are same as what we had a look at in active threads over time. Let's plot next graph, which is server hits per second. So let's add this. Somewhere here we have hits per second, and I would add this now. Let me plot the test result file here. So these are the number of server hits which are happening or which happened during the test. And then we have response time percentile. So let's plot this also. Listener, response time percentile is here. And I would load our test result file. So here are the response time percentile for create account, registration, and welcome page. As you might know, that percentile is the value which specifies the timing which is taken by the samples. So if I look here, this is 80 percentile, which is close to 460 milliseconds. It means 80 percentile of welcome page is 460 milliseconds. So it means all of the transactions for welcome page have their values of 80 percentile set to 460 milliseconds. Hence, total transactions all happened either in this time or, as you can see, in the time which is less than this. But if you go beyond 80 percentile, then the time taken is more than 460 milliseconds. So 80 percentile is 460 milliseconds. In the similar way, we can analyze percentile of other samplers, and we can also see 90, 95, or 100 percentiles. And next we have composite graph. So composite graph is something which is very interesting because we can combine various graphs using composite graph. So let's see how we do that. So let me add composite graph now, which is here. All right, so you see here there is no data available right now. This is because we have already plotted data in different listeners. So we have to clear it and load it again, and then we will see the data in composite graph. So let me hit Control E, which would clear it. And let me add active thread over time data again. So I have plotted it again. Let's go back to composite graph. Okay, so we have first graph listed here, which is thread group one and overall active graph. So I would just double click on it. And now I have overall active threads, which I can see here. I would uncheck the marker so the graph is more clear. All right, so this is only one graph. I would like to plot, for example, response time graph with the active threads to see how response time behaved with number of threads. So let me go to response time over time and let me load the test file again. All right, and now let's go back to composite graph. And if you see in the graph section, we have another element come up, which is response time over time, and we have welcome page, registration page, account page, and overall response time. So consider that you want to plot the welcome page response time, then just double click on it, and now you have welcome page response time being plotted here with respect to the number of threads. In the similar way, you can also select create account page, and then you will see the create account response times also being plotted here. One thing to note here is that active thread over time has been scaled up by 100. Hence, there are only three threads, but you see it at the line of 300 because it is upscaled. This is done so that we could visualize this better with the response times. In the similar manner, we can also plot active thread and the number of transactions. So let's go back to transactions per second. Let me browse the test result file. So we have transactions available here. Let's go back to the composite graph. Let me clear the old graph set. I would bring up the overall active thread again, and then I would select transactions. So I want to figure out how many transactions were happening for welcome page for the given number of thread. So I have selected welcome page here. And now you can see here that initially I had same amount of transactions happening for welcome page, but somewhere at 1 minute, the number of transactions reduced. So these are the kind of things which we would have to observe from test results and figure out why this is happening. What is that which is causing the transactions per second or throughput to drop after a certain period of time? Now I can remove welcome page and I can plot registration page. So this is my registration page graph with respect to the number of threads, or registration page transactions per second graph with respect to number of threads. Since the color is not very visible here, so I will double click on it and change it. All right, this is better. This is also okay. So this is how you can plot different graphs, and then you can combine them and do more analysis of your results and see how what happens in your application responses or transactions or number of hits with respect to the number of threads. I usually plot these graphs and then take snapshots of those and put it in part of my final report and then make it available to my entire team. So we saw lots of things in this session. We figured out how we can use JMeter plugin to plot custom graphs, why we need custom graphs, how we can plot different results using custom graphs. Using custom listeners, not custom graphs. And then we also had a look at composite graph, which can be used to combine lots of results from different listeners. That's about it in this session. Please hit the like button if you find this video educational and subscribe to my channel. Keep learning till I post my next video. So see you around in next video. Have fun. Bye-bye.